Cape Cod is an incredibly crowded tourist mecca in the summertime. Good thing it's not the summertime. Right now, in the springtime, the Cape is a paradise of free beachside boondocking. I'm going to tell you about it.
Maximalist Minibus with Mary and Captain and you. Get on the bus!
I have something I need to do before we go to the beach. It's Mother's Day weekend, and part of the reason I wanted to come down here now is it's my first Mother's Day without a mother. And I just, since I happen to be in Massachusetts, I wanted to come and visit the National Cemetery, which is the place where she's buried. Well, not buried, you know, interred, I guess is what you'd say. She and my dad, their ashes are in a columbarium here. Basically, it's a wall. I've been down here a bunch of times with my mom when she was alive, because my dad's been in the columbarium, the wall, since 2017. We used to come for dad's birthday, for Father's Day, the anniversary of his death. At some point, we'd usually make our way down here during the Christmas season, sometimes with other family members. Sometimes just, you know, the two of us, me and my mom. But every time we came, no matter who came, we would sing Sweet Caroline to my dad, because that's like the theme song of the Boston Red Sox. I don't understand why it's the theme song of the Boston Red Sox. My brother Sean could probably explain it because he's into the Red Sox too. But it's kind of weird to be here without her, or, you know, with her in the wall. That's her right there, Lovey. That's what Dad called her. That's what she called him too. Sweet Caroline, bum, bum, bum. I don't know the rest of the words. Okay, it's time for the beach. This is Marconi Beach. It's in Wellfleet. We headed here because dogs are allowed on the beaches in Wellfleet, even in the summertime. Most of the beaches down here, dogs can't come after April 1st, so it's too late to bring him to pretty much most of the beaches on the Cape. Ladies and gentlemen, the Atlantic Ocean. Right now, the only people at the beach are these kids that are playing soccer over here. Starting next week, it's probably going to be wall-to-wall, out of control.
This is Captain's second time at the ocean. First time was at Assateague Island.
My first dog, Indy, loved the water so much that I had to get him a little floaty life jacket. He'd be running straight for the waves right now, but Captain is booking it in the other direction. I don't really blame him. The sand is blowing around a lot, and I bet he's getting it in his eyes.
I thought I was going to have to carry Captain up the stairs, but he was doing it two at a time. He was doing great. Me, on the other hand, my knee gave out.
I was thinking about what I was expecting at the cemetery this morning.
I was hoping I would really feel her presence. I never felt my dad's presence that strongly, but I was never there in that physical place with my dad alive. My mom, I've been there with her alive, and now I've been there with her not alive, and I just wanted to talk to me. Just say one thing. Just pass me one very clear message. And it hasn't really happened yet. I wanted to bring Captain to see her because, you know, that's a little guy. He was her favorite person in the world, human or otherwise. But they had signs everywhere that said no dogs. So he had to stay in the bus and stay hidden. And it's kind of ironic to me that my mom is buried in a place that says no dogs.
Let's check the facilities out. Bathrooms, pretty good, pretty clean. There are outdoor showers, and then, women's dressing room. I wonder if there's a shower in there, too. There's little booths to change your clothes in. No doors, but something. And the shower. Well, there are walls, but there's no roof on this, so I'm not sure it's going to be any warmer than the outdoor shower. Let's do a temperature check. Very slightly warm, but not warm enough.
We're going to see if we can get away with sleeping here tonight. I didn't see any gates on the way in, and it's a huge, huge parking lot that's pretty much empty.
I don't know if all these spaces are full during the high season, but if they even built a parking lot like this, you can bet it gets pretty crowded here.
I don't know how policed it is, so I guess we'll just have to see. I mean, got no crazier things.
Well, we made it through the night. No ranger, nobody said boo to us. It was pitch dark here and very, very quiet. At one point, a car came through. I saw headlights that came in and then went right back out again. But otherwise, we were completely alone and I could hear the ocean all night. This morning, we took a walk, a pretty long walk, in this woodsy area that's right off the parking lot. Captain would have walked all day if I didn't insist we come back. Sometimes it's hard to remember that that guy's 14 years old. I think we're going to stick around on the Cape for a little while because, you know, might as well take advantage of it while we can, because this is the last week that this is even a possibility, because the season starts next week. If you want to check this place or any other beaches on the Cape out for yourself, you've got to come before Memorial Day for sure. And also just pay attention to the temperature, because in Massachusetts in the spring, might be winter one day, summer the next. If it's warm, all bets are off. According to what it says online, this particular parking lot is open until midnight. I've never been here during the season, so I can't vouch for whether or not there's actually people around until midnight, but I can tell you that I didn't see a gate on this driveway, so I don't think you're going to get locked out or locked in. Give it a shot. During the season, it costs $15 to park here. That's just parking for the day. That's not camping. But the parking is free if you have an America the Beautiful pass. As for actual camping, there are campgrounds on the Cape in state parks, but they are expensive. They're over $30 for Massachusetts residents and over $80 a night for non-residents. To me, that is crazy. You can camp for free in the National Seashore Off-Road Corridor, but it's very restrictive in terms of what the vehicle is that you can be here in. You have to get a permit, and they inspect. They actually inspect. I can't do it because one of the rules is you have to have a permanently installed black tank. No bucket toilets. I don't even think a composting toilet would pass muster. You're also camping on sand, so you have to let the air out of your tires. They make you go down to, I think, 15 pounds. But if you're willing to just come down before the season starts, parking lots like this one, they're a pretty good option. I've also stayed in like shopping plazas and stuff without any problems. No guarantees, but it's worked out well for us. Okay, check this one out. And remember, subscribers are cool. You are cool. Therefore, you should be a subscriber. See you next time.
Hey!